Hey guys, right here I have a 2013 Peugeot 5008. And today I'm gonna make a startup and full vehicle tour video of it, show you the features inside and out. So, here's the key. Let's go ahead and start it up first. As you can see, the mirrors are currently folded out. Upon locking the car, it will automatically fold in. And upon unlocking, it will fold out again. This car has 4,204 kilometers.
The 5008 comes with an electro-hydraulic power steering system controlled via a leather-wrapped steering wheel. The steering wheel itself is quite sporty. It has sport grips at the 10 and 2 o'clock positions, as well as the 4 and 8 o'clock positions, and a flat bottom design. The only transmission available for the 5008 in Malaysia is a 6-speed automatic with the ability to adapt to one's driving characteristics. Included within the gearbox is a Tiptronic mode via the plus and minus down by the gear lever, as well as sport and winter modes activated using the buttons on the left of the transmission housing. Shifting the car into reverse activates the parking sensor display on the media screen. The parking brake for the 5008 is electronic. When the symbol on the lever is illuminated red, that means the parking brake is engaged. To disengage it, put your foot on the brake and pull on it once. To engage it back, just simply pull on it once more. Safety in the sole 5008 variant in Malaysia gets you 6 airbags, hill start assist, electronic stability program, anti-lock braking system with electronic brake force distribution and brake assist, anti-skid regulation, dynamic stability control, dead locking, immobilizer, and ISOFIX child seat anchor points for the second row seats. As usual, let's go ahead and turn on the hazards, lights, front and rear fog lights, the bonnet release is down by the passenger side footwell, and roll down the driver's side window. All the windows in this car are fully automatic in both ways. The 5008 comes with 17-inch Quark 5 twin-spoke alloy rims with Michelin Primacy HP 21550 R17 tyres. Brakes are front ventilated discs and rear solid discs. Suspension consists of independent McPherson struts with drop-link anti-roll bars in the front and a deformable U-shaped cross-member rear located by two arms and a hollow anti-roll bar. Peugeot is known for making small family hatchbacks such as the 206 and 308. They also do have some saloons, coupes, coupe convertibles, and vans that are marketed in certain places where Peugeot is present. What Peugeot does not have are crossovers and MPVs to play with their rivals. Hence, in 2009, Peugeot launched the 3008 crossover and 5008 compact MPV. Both these cars are closely related to each other with a near identical engine lineup available. The 5008 also represents the re-entry of Peugeot into the MPV market, albeit this time the compact MPV segment, after the large 807 MPV was discontinued. As mentioned before, there is only one 5008 variant available in Malaysia. The engine chosen for this variant is from the Prince engine family. It is a 1.6-litre, dual-overhead cam, 16-valve, turbocharged inline 4 with direct injection and variable valve timing. Utilizing a twin-scroll turbo high-pressure setup, or THP in short, the engine produces 156 horsepower at 6000 RPM and 240 Nm of torque at 1400 RPM. 0 to 100 is achieved in approximately 10.8 seconds onto a top speed of around 195 km per hour. Fuel tank for the 5008 is 60 liters and the combined fuel consumption is 7.9 liters per 100 km. Carbon dioxide emissions are rated at 179 grams per kilometer and the 5008 is front wheel drive. The 5008 is built on the same extended PSA PF2 platform as other PSA products such as the Peugeot 308SW, Peugeot 408, and Citroën DS5. This compact MPV was launched in Malaysia back at the 2010 Kuala Lumpur International Motor Show with the aforementioned single variant option. As for the exterior features, the 5008 comes with automatic halogen reflector headlights, automatic wipers, front and rear fog lights, front and rear parking sensors, LED rear lights, dual exhausts, and follow me home function for the headlights.
Got your storage space down here, speaker, mirror controls, window controls, child lock and window lock for the rear doors. Front quarter windows. You do have your parking space measurement button right there. When activated, the car will scan for an available parking space to see whether the car can fit into that space and how difficult it will be to get into that space. You do have the button to turn off your parking sensors as well as your traction control. Headlight level adjustment with some storage down there and storage down here. Peugeot door sills and the driver's seat in this car comes with electric adjustments. This is for your seat back, this is for your seat position, seat height, and seat inclination, with your heated seat controls right here. Alright, so let's go ahead and see how she revs. right down here, you have your dual zone automatic climate control system, fan speed in the middle, your different modes, recirculation, front and rear defrost to activate your rear air conditioning, automatic, driver side temperature, passenger side temperature. And this car does come with your original Peugeot head unit with, I believe, 6 speakers. Sound quality is decent, not the best, not the worst either. You do have your CD player right there to switch between your different modes. Dark enables you to turn off the display partially or completely. To change between your different source, your different bands, FM, AM. For source, you do have your CD, auxiliary, USB, Bluetooth audio streaming. Your sound system setup with your balance, fader, automatic volume, your musical ambience, bass, treble, loudness correction, your 6 customizable stations, and this set of return, menu, OK, up, down, left, right buttons right here, you can actually control a simple menu system for the car. Hit menu. You can have your audio functions, your personalization configuration settings, your lights, signaling, parking assistance, and all that good stuff. Your date and time units, language, and you can also configure your Bluetooth setup through this menu. Right up here, you have your central locking. It is electronic.
The 2 buttons between the hazard lights and central locking buttons are for your distance warning alert system.
Right here, you have the controls for your heads-up display. You can either close it, turn it on, your brightness, the height of the display, power folding mirrors, make sure the switch is in the middle, and then just pull on it. Wiper controls, light and indicator controls, cruise control, audio controls located behind the steering wheel. You do have your volume behind to change between your different tracks or radio stations, up top and at the bottom to change between your different source. power outlet, sunshade control for the panoramic glass roof. The glass portion does not actually open, so it's just a glass roof rather than an actual sunroof. But you do have the shade for it if you do not want the light coming in. You do have quite a large center console right down here. Your auxiliary and USB ports is actually located right down here inside the center console. If I'm not wrong, it is refrigerated as well. Small little cup holder with some storage. Armrest, it is adjustable. Auto dimming, rear view mirror with a smaller mirror right up top to check your rear passengers. Seatbelt warning. Sun visor with a vanity mirror and light. Sunglass holder. Also, if you hit this button right here, it will actually perform a diagnosis of the car. Alright, so I guess that's it for the startup. We can turn it off right now. And continue with the rest of the tour. You do have some storage right down here with your speaker, window control. Sunshades for the rear windows. Individual seats for the second and the third row. And to climb to the back, just pull this lever. And move the seat forward. Once in the last row though, headroom is quite limited. Legroom is also an issue. I don't really feel comfortable in here. Probably for a short journey, but not a long one. However, you still do get cup holders, some storage, a sunshade for both sides, your seat belts and whatnot.
The second row seat positions are also adjustable, and there are storage holes in the second row footwell.
You do get storage pockets on the front seat backs, a tray table on both sides as well, and screens for, again, both front seat bags. Obviously, the power is not on, so I can't really show you much. But you do have your controls right up here. And more controls down here with your auxiliary inputs. And a 12-volt power outlet. And you also have your driver's side lumbar support using this knob right here. Your interior light right there, hook, and your aircon vents on the B pillar with your fan speed control. There's a touchpad right beneath here that opens up the rear hatch. With the rear seats up, boot space is quite limited. You do have some storage down below. But that is actually gone once you fold down the third row seats. And this actually acts as the flap. So once you get the third row folded, boot space does increase. You can also fold down the second row seats to create more boot space. You do have a removable torch off to the right. And when connected, it doubles up as a boot light. To fold the second row seats, just locate the lever and pull on it. There are also flaps that you unlock by pulling those buttons and flipping them over, so you can create one big load space. You also do have a cargo cover should you choose to use it when the last row of seats are folded down. you do need the key to open the actual petrol cap, since this petrol door isn't actually lockable when you lock the car, but it is still protected in a way that you need the key to open the petrol cap. You do have adjustable headrests, front and back. And the front passenger seat has manual adjustments. This is for your seat height, this is for your seat back, and this is for your seat position with your heated seats control right here. Glove box is not very huge, it is actually quite small. Alright, so let's start it up with the door closed. Alright, so let's take the 5008 for a quick test drive. Alright, so that's it for the startup and full vehicle tour video of this 2013 Peugeot 5008. Thanks for watching, and goodbye.